Get ready to match the stars. Dick Martin. Red Summers. Charles Nelson Reilly. From Legs, Laurie Mahaffey. From Family Feud, Richard Dawson. And Joyce Buliffont. As we play the star-studded big money match game, PM. And now, here's the star of match game, PM, Gene Rayburn.
What does that mean?
That's interesting.
Oh, isn't that a great effect?
I got a free game.
Isn't that a great effect? Hey, should we do that again? No, let's get right on with it now. I greet you one and all. You're just so beautiful. My heart chokes in my mouth.
You're really a handsome bunch. And now would all the stars join me in applauding Sue Bainey and Willard Johnson.
Now, before we begin, we'd like to find out a little bit about you. And you, to begin with you, Willard. Tell us where you're from, anything you want to contribute.
I'm a police officer in the city of Los Angeles, 14 and a half years. Part-time instructor in public administration at California State University at Dominguez Hills. And presently an outpatient at West Hills Community Hospital with a back injury, off-duty.
Oh, really?
Yes.
An off-duty back injury?
On-duty injury.
Oh.
I'm presently off-duty with the injury.
Yes.
Right.
Someone push you? Okay, well, good luck to you. Sue, tell us about you.
Well, I'm from Riverside, and
yeah.
I work as a manager in a little dress store in Riverside.
Yeah.
I'm married. We've been married 13 years.
That's
and
nice.
We have two puppies.
Two puppies?
Two puppies.
Yes.
Yeah.
What kind?
Maltese and West Highland Terrier.
Well, that's nifty,
oh,
Sue.
Right.
Good luck to both of you.
Thank you.
Here on Match Game PM, as you know, if you've probably seen it, and I'm sure you have, I hope you have, you, each of you will have three opportunities to match as many of the creatures from the Dark Lagoon as you possibly can. The one who's done that most often at the end of the third round will be the winner. Go on to play the big money super match, which could pay off over $20,000. Wow, how about that? We'll get right to it here. You have the first selection, Willard, A or B?
I'll take B.
Willard says he wants B.
Uh-huh.
He can have anything he wants.
B is
it. What do I care? Willard, here it is. Mary said, my husband really loves junk food. If he had catered the Last Supper, today they would serve blanks at communion. My husband, he loves junk food. See, if he had catered the Last Supper, today they'd be serving blanks at communion. Here it is. Mary said, my husband really loves junk food. If he had catered the Last Supper, today they'd serve blanks at communion.
Cookies.
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 Yes. Cookies, you say,
cookies.
Willard, right? Okay, Willard. What do you say there, Dick?
Cookies is a broad range.
Yes, well, junk
shot.
Food, I thought, was the operative phrase here.
Yes,
and cookies,
said,
I don't think.
Twinkies.
Twinkies! You were close with cookies, but Twinkies and cookies do not match. Twinkies, that's real junk food.
Mother Nature doesn't like it unless you say hot dogs and malteds.
That's junk food? Any
that's
of that
junk food. That's the worst kind of junk food.
Any of that quick stuff, yes, especially with the sodium nitrites in them and all that. What do you say?
Boy, I hope people that have tape recorders are taping these things. It's unbelievable what they're getting in the afternoon across the country.
For this money.
For this. Now, you're right. Twinkies is very good, but it has to be more religiosized.
Uh-huh.
Religioso-sized.
Oh.
The Heavenly Host?
Yes.
You have to write the whole thing. Host.
Hostess Twinkies, right, yeah.
That's even better.
Right. Okay, we got the idea, Chuck. Yep. Laurie, if he had catered the Last Supper, this guy who likes junk food, today they'd serve blanks at communion instead of, you know, the... What do you got?
My
Twinkies.
Favorite.
Twinkies. Really? All right, so there we have Twinkies several times. Show us your Twinkies.
Big Macs.
Big Macs. Ah! All right, show us yours now.
I really don't want to.
Really?
You have to read
junk food. My husband really loves junk food. If they had catered the Last Supper today, they would serve...
carburetors.
What?
Carburetors?
Well, don't you find those in junkyards?
Fanny Flagg lives.
Fanny Flagg lives. Carburetors? Now, look, my dear. Junkyard is a place where old automobiles go to die.
Right, that's where you find carburetors.
No, but yeah, I know that. But we're not talking about junkyards. We're talking about junk food.
That would be junk food.
Oh, my dear. There is no way I can explain myself to this lady. Because she doesn't want to understand. I am misunderstood, Sue. Nobody understands me. Nobody understands me. Unlucky Louie said... I just won the world's worst contest. The first prize is a week in blank. First prize. A week in blank. And you look elegant, my dear. We'll go to the ball later. I'll wear my high heels and we'll have a grand time. Hello, Sue.
Hello.
Unlucky Louie said, I just won the world's worst contest. The first prize is a week in...
Los Angeles.
Sue, why did you say that?
I don't know.
Many tourists come to Los Angeles.
This is
a wonderful place if you're a grapefruit.
My goodness.
Or an orange.
Obviously, this lady has never been to Cleveland.
First prize is a week in Cleveland.
No.
This show doesn't go to Cleveland, and that's what you get, Cleveland.
Hello there.
No, darling. A week in Burbank.
Burbank!
Burbank.
Maybe that's
beautiful.
What Sue had
beautiful
in mind.
Downtown, yes. Burbank.
Right.
Gladys Knight, I love you. Forgive me, I love you. Detroit!
We don't go to Detroit either, so that's two cities on our list there that we've offended, and they'll never know about it. Yes.
Juarez,
Mexico.
Oh.
First prize is a week in Juarez, Mexico.
How did you spell it?
I've never... correctly. Where were we there?
Burbank.
Burbank it is. And now, here it is. The first prize is a week in...
carburetor!
Burbank!
You got the idea, Dick. Okay, there we are at the end of round one, and neither of our contestants have scored yet, but the round one questions are tough. They'll get easier as we go along. Now this for you. Since the score is tied, Willard went first last time. Sue, we'll ask you to go first this time. You want A or B?
I'll take B, please.
B it is. Here it is. Did you hear what happened to the 102-year-old lady at the department store?
No.
Would you like to hear what happened to the 102-year-old lady at the department store? Yes. She lost her blank in the revolving door. Ready, Sue?
I think I'm ready.
Did you hear what happened to the 102-year-old lady at the department store? She lost her blank in the revolving door.
Her fanny. It's not great, but that's...
She lost her fanny?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. She didn't move fast enough.
No. Whoops. Whole thing came being just... Well, that could happen, I suppose. What do you say, Dick?
102-year-old grandmothers do not have fannies.
Right.
Just a minute.
Okay.
No, she lost her grandmother.
She lost her grandmother.
She was 208.
That's right.
No, the poor little darling. She lost her last chance for love or her innocence.
In the revolving door. Go to run.
Oh, that's smart. Virginity.
So far, we have two of those, Sue. Laurie, this 102-year-old lady at the department store lost her blank in the revolving door. What do you make of that?
This is really tacky. Her bra.
Lost her bra. It happened. She didn't move fast enough. Must have hurt a little, too.
Her virtue.
Her virtue, eh? And you, my dear?
She was always hanging around there. And she got shoved too fast, and she lost her teeth.
That'll happen. It could happen. So, Sue? Willard, you ready?
I'm ready.
Yes.
Yes.
Okay, Willard. Wendy the widow said, I treasure the memory of my husband. When he died, I cut off his blank and put it in a safe deposit box. Charles will try and figure it out now. All right, Willard, are you ready?
We're just yes, I'm ready. Here.
Here we go.
No,
Wendy the widow said, I treasure the memory of my husband. When he died, I cut off his blank and put it in a safe deposit box.
Would you repeat that question, please?
Well, all right. She said, I treasure the memory of my husband. When he died, I cut off his blank and put it in a safe deposit box.
I cut off his head.
Head, certainly. Memory. She wanted the memory of him.
Memory.
I don't think she wanted memory at all. Like, she cut off his allowance.
Cut off his allowance. All right.
Oh, I said she cut off his golden locks.
Oh, that's it. Little lock of hair. Lock of hair. The people do that often as a memento of a loved one or a child or something like that. What do you say to this? I cut off his blank and put it in a safe deposit box.
So I just put wedding ring.
Wedding ring is her response. When he died, I cut off his blank and put it in a safe deposit box, Richard.
Shorts.
His shorts. Anything as a memory. All right. What did Wendy the widow say here? Come on, Joyce.
I said his finger.
His finger. Okay. There we go. Well, folks, those of you who are gathered in this great hall here can see very plainly that we still have a hard-fought battle here. A zip-to-zip tie. Who went first last time? Sue went first last time, so Willard, you go first this time.
I'll take A.
A. All right, Willard. At the appliance store, Mr. Toaster said, I hate the way Mr. Refrigerator treats Mrs. Refrigerator. Every night he leaves her blank.
Every night he leaves her blank?
I hate the way Mr. Refrigerator treats Mrs. Refrigerator. Every night he leaves her blank. We're ready for it. At the appliance store, Mr. Toaster said, I hate the way Mr. Refrigerator treats Mrs. Refrigerator. Every night, he leaves her blank.
He leaves her cold.
Cold it is. It appears that we're going to finally get a match here. What do you got?
We have finally a match.
Finally, we got one. Yay, Willie Johnson.
Well, I didn't say cold. I said he leaves her open, and then it's just as soon as she gets warmed up, the store opens.
I see.
You're
right about Brett.
No, I didn't say cold because that's the thing the refrigerator should be, I think. I don't know. Yeah. I said open with the light on.
Open with the light on. He leaves her cold. That would be the phrase. I'm a surprise there. Hello, Laurie.
Hello, Gene.
How are you, my dear?
Well, I'm doing
every this. Night he leaves her...
cold, Willard.
Cold. Here's the Willard. What do you say about this little gossip? Oh, there's another one for Willard. He's up to three.
It's all right.
Now, I know you're embarrassed about it, but you must show it.
He leaves her empty.
Really? So Willard has picked up three. And Sue, you need three to tie and four to win.
Aha, uh-huh. That old trick.
Dumdor is really dumb.
How dumb is she?
She wanted a bouncing baby, so she made love to her husband on a blank. That's how dumb she is. Here we go, Sue. Dumdor is really dumb, Sue. You've heard about her. She wanted a bouncing baby, so she made love to her husband on a blank.
On a ball.
On a ball?
Like a big beach ball.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
See, they had a ball, but it would be difficult. It would be difficult to do what you have in mind.
However, if you have any pictures, I'd kind of like to see them.
Made love on a trampoline.
Trampoline!
Perk up, Sue. All is not lost. Oh, have good. A ball on the ball.
Made love in a ball, she said. What do you say to
you
that?
You should know. I said a pogo stick.
A pogo stick.
Well, those are the things that go like that.
Yes. Go on. Boing, boing, boing. Are you ready for yours?
Don't laugh, Gene. Pogo stick.
Pogo stick. Two of those. Now, you must match Richard and Joyce to stay in the game and achieve a tie. What have we got there, Richard?
Trampoline.
Trampoline. So that means Willa Johnson wins the game. She has trampoline, too. Okay, a little blue dot, if you would, please. Sue Bainey, it was a pleasure to meet you.
Well, thank you so much. I enjoyed myself very, very much.
Good, Sue. We'll send some gifts to you from Match Game PM.
Thank
Goodbye,
you.
My dear. I was spinning her off. We've got a spin a message too, just for you. You got it. Here we go. Willard, it's time now for this big money super match where you could win over $20,000. Now, to do that, we're going to have two audience matches for you. Let's begin with the first one. We polled a studio audience, a nice bunch like these here one day, and we said, write down your best answer to this. Blank wreck. If you match the answer they wrote down most often, you get $500. For matching their second most popular response, $250, then $100 for matching the third. Three of our six stars will give you a hand.
Take Richard.
Shipwreck.
Shipwreck. There's one.
I'll take Charles.
Charles. Blank. Wreck.
Nervous wreck.
Nervous wreck. Okay.
And I will take Brett.
What have you got, Brett?
But I am sitting next to Charles. I'm a wreck. I'm a wreck. I'm a wreck.
I am a wreck.
It stinks.
I'm a wreck, shipwreck, and nervous wreck are the three they have suggested. Now, at this point, you may reject all of those and give us one of your own, or choose one of those. What is your pleasure?
Shipwreck.
Shipwreck. Sounds like a good idea to me, one Richard gave you. Let's find out if it works. We'll begin at the bottom and reveal the $100 response. Nervous wreck is one that Charles gave you.
Bob Martin.
Right. May we see the $250 number?
Car wreck.
All right. I think it's a pretty good shot there. That shipwreck is going to be up there since these two have shown up. All right, let's see the big one, if you please. Shipwreck. Congratulations there. All right. Now, Willis, since you won the $500, it means the least you can be playing for is 10 times that amount or $5,000. But at this moment, Willard, we're going to see how much more you'll win with the second audience match. Thanks for blank. All right. You may have, choose three celebrities to give you a little assistance here.
I'll go with Richard first.
Thanks for the memory.
Right.
Charles second.
Thanks for nothing.
And Brett.
What, dear? Thanks a million.
Thanks a million. So you got thanks a million, thanks for the memory, and thanks for nothing.
I choose thanks for nothing.
Thanks for nothing. You don't like that.
Thanks for the memory.
What would you say? Memory. They would say thanks for the memory. All right, let's find out if it's up there. May we see the $100 response? Thanks for everything.
Here it comes.
Okay, you gonna think it's gonna be here? All right, slide the $250, please. Thanks for nothing. But I guess maybe the audience is right. Thanks for the memory has been a big hit song for many years. It's really because, you know, Bob Hope's used it as a theme song. I would feel certain it's up there. Let's find out right now. Thanks for the memories, it is. All right. You've won another $250 multiplied by 10 is $2,500. We add that to the previous $5,000, making $7,500. Now, that's the least you can play for. However, you can double that $7,500 and play for $15,000 if you have a lucky spin of the wheel here. The wheel will determine which star you'll be playing with and for how much, either $7,500 or $15,000. Give it a good spin. It must make one complete revolution. There it is.
That's
powerful.
That's what I like to see, man.
It's perfectly coordinated so that if it stops in a starred section, the
double
light will stay lighted. And we're going to find out right now if it's going to stay.
Hey,
So $7,500 is the amount you'll be playing for with Brett Summers, and here we go, and good luck to you. Are you ready, Brett?
No, but go ahead.
Here it is. Blank a chance. It's blank a chance. C-H-A-N-C-E. There it is. Well, she finished very quickly, Willard. You give us the answer that matches hers. If you do that, you get $7,500, which ain't bad. What do you say?
Give me a chance.
Give me a chance.
Give me a chance.
Yes. I think the audience is trying to tell you something here that I think give me a chance might not be the answer that they had in mind. Brett, what do you say?
Oh, Willard, I thought it was a shoe-in.
Yes, take a chance. Willard, you won a grand total of $750, and that's not bad. We congratulate you for that. Now we've got this message for you. Thank you all. Join us next week for Match Game PM. Gene Rayburn here. Goodbye.
Some contestants will receive the Amana Touch Pilot 2 radar range microwave oven with an automatic temperature control system. Remember, if it doesn't say Amana, it's not a radar range. And the match... Slow starts, bucking and stalling, gum out, the between tune-ups, tune-up. This is Johnny Olson speaking for Match Game PM, a Mark Goodson, Bill Trotman production.